Hey everyone, Gabriel Nassif for Ultimate Garden Channel Fireball, and today I'm going to be playing some Modern. I'm going to be playing this sweet blue-eyed affinity deck I've been playing with. I played a few leagues with it. I played it at a challenge to put it to the test. Went pretty well. It was going well in leagues. I went 9-1 over two leagues. Gave it a try in the challenge. I went 5-3, which is not bad. I actually ended up losing a couple times to Hammer Time, which I beat in the leagues. I think I got a little unlucky, and I think maybe my sideboard was a little bit off. So this is the updated version after that challenge, and the main deck hasn't changed too much. I'm gonna try cutting the Force Nettle Cyst and the Force Rebuke for a casket and an extra relic. But before I go into details, I guess I should talk a bit about the deck. It's inspired by some of the people who've been playing Affinity in Modern. Most people, or most lists I've seen, are either mono blue or mono blue splashing green for Neoform and Crater Hoof, which is kind of a cool take. And they play more of the affinity creatures. They play Cranial Plating, and they don't play the white card. Other inspiration was a historic deck I've played, originally built by Aaron Gertler, I believe. So that's on Arena, and it's extremely similar. You don't get Urza's Saga in historic. You don't get Thoughtcast, but you get a lot of the other cards. You get Ingenious Mist and Thought Monitor for card advantage. You have Portable Hole and Esper Sentinel. So this version gets upgrades. Huge upgrade. Honestly, Urza's Saga is the best card, except when they have Alpine Moon, Blood Moon, or Spreading Seas. But otherwise, that card is unreal in the deck. And I wanted the card advantage, and I wanted the control of that Portable gives you, the removal. I wanted the annoying Sentinel that slots in perfectly in this deck. So yeah, that's kind of the idea behind the deck. Portable Hole is really good right now. Also, you get to play main deck Relics, which can be really key in some matchups. So that's a nice bonus. I got some one-offs. I got my Urza's Saga target. Flare Husk, kind of a weird one. It was originally a Memnite, and I figured I would try the Husk. It trades with Ragavan, and it leaves an artifact behind for Affinity or Rebuke, which can be nice. So that card's been okay. Some zeros. The mana base is a little tricky, just because you need early blue and early white, but you also want to play Urza's Saga and play as many artifact lands as possible. So you'll see I have 7, 8, 12... I have 14 sources of blue and 14 sources of white, including 10 that come into play untapped on turn 1. Actually, I only have 2 Seachrome Coast. Okay, yeah, why not? Because you don't want to play too many lands, or else you're going to have too many lands in your opening hand and not get on the board fast enough, and you need critical mass of artifact. But you need enough lands that you can actually cast your colored spells. So you would think, oh, 2 color, Modern, how hard can it be? But it's not that easy. If you've tried building mana bases for Ren and 6 decks and play Urza's Saga in your deck, you probably ran into the same problem where you don't want to play too many lands because you already have Ren and 6. That kind of, once you have a fetch land and a Ren and 6, you basically don't even want to draw another land for the rest of the game. But you also need to fit the Urza's Saga and have enough dual lands and fetch lands that your mana is functional. So not all tricky, and one Tasman on progress, one drum, that helps a bit too. I started with Nettle Cyst and Rebuke as kind of playing what the historic deck played. I think Nettle Cyst is fine, but maybe there's something better I should be playing. Maybe you don't even really need Nettle Cyst. But yeah, I decided to trim, and what I did was move some cards that were in my sideboard, made more room, and I used to only have 2 or 3 Glass Casket, or maybe 4, and only 2 Dispatch. But I want to go up to 4 Dispatch. I think that card's good against Hammer Time. It's especially good because it's instant speed against Nexus. You're a little weak to Nexus plus Hammer. because you don't have a ton of flyers. So yeah, that's the reasoning. Then you've got kind of the some of the usual suspect, a chalice, a force relic, Grabdigger's Cage. Might be a little overkill to have the Grabdigger's Cage. I even had a Rest in Peace at first. Teferi's a good card, could be in the main. Veto is pretty solid, even though I haven't really played a ton of matchups where I brought in Veto so far. But yeah, that's it for the deck. I'm going to get in a league. Hoping I'm not already in a league. Sometimes I am. All right, good. All right, I'm back home. Some of you might have noticed. So back to, home sweet home. I was stuck in the US for a little while, a few extra days, but it was all good in the end. I actually got a one trophy, which I haven't been getting a ton of trophies, honestly, recently in Modern. I got a bunch in the Vintage Cube. All right, great hand. Honestly, when I build a deck, I was hopeful, but I didn't have high expectations. I wasn't even sure the deck would be functional. I was worried it would just not do enough and just not be very good. And it's been surprisingly good. So yeah, I was happy. It's been a little while since I wouldn't say even I built a new deck because it kind of transformed from Historic, but still. Felt good to bring something all new to the table that was functional as well. So it looks like, I would say Elementals, but they don't have a Yorion. All right, Amulet Titan. I haven't played this matchup, and do I even have anything to... Huh. All right, I wouldn't mind countering a Dryad, but I probably should get on the board and use my mana efficiently. Grab Thought Monitor. Amulet Titan. That might just be a really bad matchup. We'll see. Can't think of anything I really have in my deck that you care about. I have Portable Hole for Amulet. Some removal for the Dryad, but that's not exactly what dreams are made of. All right. So next turn, they potentially have Titan. So let's see. Play a Relic. Play Island Shadow Sphere or Bridge. I guess Island Shadow Sphere is kind of better. Can't do much but say go here. I guess I didn't have to tap the Relic right away. Still have the mana for Rebuke. I'm not sure I'm going to win. Maybe they play it slow. I'm not pressuring them. Bounce their Cavern, replay Cavern of Titan, cast Titan. We'll see. All right, quick look. Maybe Dispatch. All right. They are down to one card in hand. Dad going for me. Mulligan. Not that it matters now. Mulligan to 5. Mulligan to 5 in the game still doesn't feel great. All right, I can 1, 2, 3, 4. I can cast Monitor or equip Shadow Spear now to get a hit in. That might be better, honestly. I don't even play Urza Saga. There's not a ton I can draw into, and nothing I can cast this turn anyways. Yeah, maybe I'll like just equipping. All right, I need to dodge what? Free draw steps, maybe? Something like that. Uh-oh. Oh, wait, they're just attacking. Don't do it. Okay. Not a relic. Might as well play it first. Okay. Where's this saga? I could get to a point where... Let's see. Let's sack these relics. Is that one or two? One. Wow, and I drew a rebuke. Could get to a point where I can beat a resolve titan. So we know they have caverns, so rebuke. Not the greatest. Let's see, they have four. It's good against Karn. Alright, I guess I'll just say go. Can also just sack relic enough turn. Alright, Radiant Fountain. Metal cyst. Probably just play Nettle Cyst and equip, right? Or I can make a token, play a Smith, make a token. You're at 10. They have a reach blocker. Have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 artifact, 14, 14. Oh yeah, okay. I do have a few artifacts in play, eh? Let's see. I send sentinels in too. Didn't do the math, but sentinels are not doing anything for me. I'm guessing they have two. Yeah, okay. Alright, well. That was a lucky. And they even have Karn in their deck. Jeez. Spellbomb's not really gonna save me. Welding Jar doesn't do much. Could bring in Chalice just for Pact. It's not great, but might be better than some other stuff I have. And then Portable Hole basically only hits Amulet. But it's pretty important to get rid of Amulet. Glass Casket hits the Dryad. I could bring in Veto for Karn. Impact. The Fairy doesn't seem great. Dispatch is probably good. I might be able to win a game just by dispatching their creature. Sentinel doesn't do much, but it's a cheap artifact. Does a little. Metal Cyst always feels a tiny bit slow. Was okay this game. Four. Probably don't want four Portable Hole. Maybe three. Four Amulets. The nice thing is my cards are not too terrible against Karn, so I've got that kind of going for me. And then how many caskets and vetoes do I want? I could even cut the bubble, honestly. Then I don't even have a cantrip to get with Saga. You almost always want to get Shadow Sphere with Saga anyways. Sorry, I haven't played this matchup, so I'm trying to figure stuff out. I guess Talisman's pretty bad against Karn, so I can cut that. I have Rebuke for Karn. All tough to keep mana up for Veto. I'm going to try this. I don't know about 4 Dispatch, though. Yeah, it's too many. My draws are just not going to do much. Alright, I kept 7 this time. Might be a little tougher. I have a pretty good hand too. Wish I could save that hand for game 3 when I'm on the play, honestly. Or when they don't keep a good 7 card hand. No bounce land so far. I like that. I don't think Sentinel would be unreasonable. It'll let me at least draw a card if they play a card next turn. Wow. Bricked doesn't happen very often, but yeah, 4 is Dispatch kind of hurting me. That's brutal. Yeah, I can't afford to board out Talisman when I'm already boarding out a lot of the 1 mana artifacts. Maybe keeping Spellbomb. Alright, what did they get? They got a Synergros Chamber. So they can go Amulet into Karn if they have it. Probably just ends the game on the spot, honestly. One of my lands. It's shut down, I believe. That's no good. Azusa into Karn. They can't cast Titan anymore. That's not a good sign if they're actually bothering to play the land. Means they have something. Okay. Get rid of Azusa, they actually only have 5 mana next turn. So I've got that going for me. If I had more mana, I could have just maybe kept Rebuke up, and if you rebuke the pack, they have to pay, so they can't play Titan right away, and then turn after that, they have to pay the thingy for the pact. Second Amulet does it though. Another Azusa. I think they only play one Azusa. Okay. What's that about? Reclamation Sage? What are you tutoring for? They don't seem to know themselves what they're tutoring for. Opponent? Oh, what you got? Reclamation Sage is not very exciting for them. I guess Reclamation Sage or Urza Saga. That'd be quite annoying. And what else can they do? They can get a tracker if they have tracker in their deck. They're not in super rush. They got a Grazer? I guess Grazer lets them cast Titan, right? Just gains them the 1 mana they were missing. Alright, that for giant spells, that's no good. I was kind of hopeful for a second when they took so long to tutor. I'm gonna play it out because if they don't get the right lands and I top deck a dispatch, I could maybe turn it around. So let's see what they get. If they go for the like Tolaria West bounce land line, or if they go for something more aggressive. Hmm. One, two, three artifacts, four artifacts. Let's get Springleaf Drum. Play Treasure Vault. Play Thoughtcast for one. That's not a dispatch. Play the spear. One, two, three, four, five. I've played a land. I have. Is this two mana? So I'd have to pay four pact. They have mana to like double strike their Titan. Don't believe there's anything I can draw here. All right. So what do we say? Maybe a few cheap artifacts. I think it's going to be hard to have mana for Dobbin's Veto. All right, let's do something like that. Especially on the play. You usually want less reactive cards like Dispatch on the play because it's harder to... You have one less card to play with, so it's harder to get critical mass of artifacts and whatnot. I think Dobbin's Veto is a little too clunky. They go a little too fast. It's hard to start keeping two mana up early in the game. I'm not even sure if Veto should be in my sideboard, honestly. Maybe it should just be Spell Pierce. Two mana is a lot for this deck. Two colored mana on top of that. I think my original thought was for Cascade decks on top of Chalice, but maybe it should just be like a second Chalice of the Void. I had a second Chalice of the Void at some point. Not sure these Vetoes are super great. Obviously, I was thinking maybe against Control, they could be good. But yeah, Force Rebuke, Spell Pierce probably better. Maybe only two Portable Hole. And a third Glass Casket. I don't know. I wish Relic did anything against them. Grandigar's Cage doesn't do anything against them, right? This is a cheap artifact I can run out there and don't really need to. They have access to Engineered Explosives too, I believe. Cards are all scary. Oh, did I not submit? I feel like I've submitted once already. Guess not. No, they're the one who haven't submitted yet somehow. Weird. Okay. Okay, alright. So yeah, so far, nice hand. Yeah, deck's been good. It's been really good against Grixis Shadow in results anyways. I've played against Grixis Shadow 3 or 4 times now, and I've won every time. My first loss in leagues was to Soul Sisters of all things. Oh wow, I get to draw a card. Damn, I don't have the portable hole, do I? Did I board one out? No, I kept three in. All right, great, great hand. As long as they don't have the nuts. Let's see. I want to play Urza Saga, definitely. I want to play Sentinel. Question is, do I play Chalice right away? I think I probably should. I think there's... Once in a while, their line is to go... Oh. Wow, playing Urza Saga first was kind of dumb. Damn, totally forgot about Force of Vigor. Yikes. Loose. Wow. Incredibly loose. I wonder if I should play Chalice for 0 right now. I know, so bad. Prevents me from playing Talisman. I guess either way they get my Saga and my Sentinel, and it's not like I'm doing much with the mana, so it might end up being irrelevant. I am up on cards though. Let me draw twice already. Double amulets. Drawing the wrong part of my deck. Need the portable holes. I think they only play one expedition now, right? 4 amulets. That's not a ton of targets. My portable holes. And there's some spots where they just play Amulet of Vigor the turn they go off anyways. So sometimes even when you draw a portable hole and they draw Amulet of Vigor, portable hole's not going to do much. That's why they don't have all fours. I feel like Glass Casket's pretty important for the Dryad. All right, no Titan this turn, potentially next though, if I don't draw anything good. Let's see. All right, yeah, bouncing a Titan's not gonna save me, so let's draw a card. That is not it. An Insect Expedition map. Surprise, I mean, they could even get Urza Saga, honestly. Oh, they have an Urza Saga. Yeah. Man, that Force of Vigor. I don't think this match, that's not a matchup I was prepared for at all. Or that I can really do much about, honestly. Blue-White doesn't have the greatest hate cards. There's Torpor Orb, but that stops all of my stuff too. So that's all extreme. I think if I have a solid draw, or as a side, I can be pretty good. If I draw a few cards, draw into some dispatch, I think I can maybe keep up, honestly. I mean, those draws just kind of atrocious. Didn't draw a single, draw two, or a smith. No pressure. The one side I draw got blown up. All right, there is a saga take two. They must have a bunch of packs in hand. Well, good news is my tokens are gonna be bigger than theirs, and I have a glass casket, and it appears they might have packs in hand, and Chalice is screwing them over. We'll see. They play Shadow Spear. What artifact did they get? Amulet, Expedition Map, what else? Yeah, just another amulet. Let's go, Thought Monitor. Uh-oh. But I might be playing that just to make a token. No? Yikes. Seven Colossus? Maybe that's trying to scare me. That doesn't do much. Okay. Hello, is that still? Oh, and again, I have the mana to give it double strike now next turn. All right, let's just take it. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only costs one. Okay. I mean, I feel like I might be ahead now. Glass casket, I think the dryad maybe? Gives them red mana for the double strike land. I think are my tokens gonna be? They're gonna get maybe another artifact if they have one, but maybe not, so two more, so they might have nine nines. I have a dispatch too, I still get to use. Would like to save it for a Titan potentially. I'm at 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It'll be a 10-10, but if I have to chump the other ones, then all of a sudden I'm I should just go after all the tokens. We have two cards left. Go after two tokens. And then who cares if I can just dispatch the one they tried to give double strike to. All right, I'll start with a token. I think I can be patient against Dryad. They have all the mana in the world if they have a bounce land. If they play a Titan, they can get Valakut. You know, wait for them to get Valakut and then all right, they're playing Talaria West, because I have Chalice in play anyways. So they're just trying to pump a token. But they're playing Grill Turf. Why are you playing Grill Turf now? We're good. What did they draw? Ballista? That'd be pretty nasty. That'd probably be game over. All right, they're tutoring for Ballista. Damn it. In hindsight, maybe dispatching the Dryad would have been better. I gave them, what, 8 extra mana or something dumb. I mean, either they have Ballista or Explosives. They got Valakut. Okay, maybe they don't have either of these cards. Kind of surprised. As Explosives doesn't do much for them. They don't want to do one, they don't want to do zero. If I don't block one, they're gonna know something's up. But do I care if they know? Probably do care. Kind of a tricky spot. Now I know they have Valakut, so that Dryad's all scary. I'm getting another token next turn anyways. Token trades, I'll lose my S for Sentinel. Or I can kill the token. Get Shadow Spear, equip attack. It's probably better. I don't know. I guess I messed up. I don't think I should have chomped. Well, make a token. Get Shadow Spear. Play a Smith. Portable Hole. And Glass Casket. Prop Portable Hole, because I can get rid of the token. Can I force a Trump block? 12, 13. Think I have exactly enough to force a Trump block. Might be one off. Not sure. No, I think I have exactly enough. Equip. They block Sentinel. They're dead on board. All right, nice. I think we got there somehow. Not even sure Titan still kills me, still one-shots me. Now is a Dryden play. I think they might have misplayed the early turns of the game, letting me draw two cards of Sentinel. Don't think they were in a rush, honestly. All right, well, a little good fortune here, I believe. Trying to think what you can do to make this matchup better. When do people usually play against Titans? Spreading Seas? Spreading Seas in the sideboard, I guess. That would help a tiny bit. All right, not a solid hand. I mean, nice little early turns. Just need to draw something to go along everything else. Elves-ish. I know Elves gonna be my greatest matchup. We'll see. I did have a bunch of splash removal. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to keep up. So far, so good, I guess. Mm-hmm. Okay. Free. Cast the monitor next turn for pretty cheap. Let's see. Relic, not a thought monitor. Not a bad spot. I get to draw dismiss. I have rebuke up. Counterspell pretty effective against a war master. Well, somewhat. Counter that one. That one gives them an elf and then free mana, right? So I should counter. Try to slow them down. Hope to draw into more interaction. Or maybe an Urza Saga. Might have slowed them down enough that Urza Saga can finish the job. Okay. Nice. Stuck on lands. Wow. Well, if I draw like that. How much mana does my thought monitor cost? 2? Wow, that's bullshit. So expensive. Wow. Let's fetch first. Let's play monitor first for one, see if I draw something better than a sentinel, like a rebuke. Or another monitor. Okay. Seems fair. Alright, managed to steal one. And after sideward, I guess I just load up on removal. Hope that's good enough. Maybe Wilding Jar. Can equip Sentinel, punches all extra damage in. All right, let's see. Well, relics can go. Welding Jar and Caskets can come in. Grabdigger Scooch probably decent against them, and then 4 Dispatch. Trim Nettlesis, a little slow. Sentinel, they probably play Company or Stampede or something. So it doesn't do nothing. Rebuke on the draw might be a little slow. Still a lot of cards to cut. I mean, Spellbomb, once again, don't think it's going to save me, but it is a 1-mana cheap artifact. Maybe I should trim a smith when I, the artifacts I have left. 8, 11, 15, 19, 23, 24, 28, 30, 34. I guess I'll trim a sentinel. Yeah, it's tough. I think I need all the removal spells. Can trim the bubble. Guess I can trim an artifact land maybe. On the draw. Either that or Talisman. Talisman's probably nice was 4 Dispatch, 4 Portable Hole. One artifact land and one Welding Jar. I mean, that's a lot of lands in no Urza Saga. I have 3 artifacts for my dispatch, but I don't think that's going to save me. This is not much better, but yeah, some explosiveness to this, I guess. And I don't want to go down to 5. Probably better than my 7 card hand. Did they mulligan as well? Looks like they're thinking about something. No, they're keeping 7. Alright, I'm assuming this game is not going to go super well for me. By the way, of course, video is brought to you by... Ooh, I did draw Portable Hole. think I have to play it right away. Yeah, video is brought to you by Channel Fireball and Ultimate Guard. I'd like to shout out Ultimate Guard. They have amazing deck boxes, sleeves. They have backpacks too, and they have Frozen World bundle that's going to be out soon. It's limited edition. It has some, you know, winterish colors and stuff. So definitely check it out, ultimateguard.com. And yeah, just amazing products in general. Great quality if you need sleeves, deck boxes, all that stuff. Definitely give them a look, give them a try. All right, 4 artifacts. Next turn will be 5. I'm actually gonna get punished for not getting Hallowed Fountain. Now I can't go monitor unless I draw on tableau. Kind of a big deal. I think you have to portable hole F on turn 1, because if they just bust out an Arch Root on 2, I don't have a removal for that, and then after that it's just kind of over. In hindsight, doesn't look like they had Arch Root, so maybe I wish I'd just played the bridge turn 1. One, two, three, four. All right, let's play that for the min cost. Let's play Smith now. Got a drum, so I can go. That's pretty great. The one drum's been really good. Maybe I should just play a few more. Not sure I have enough creature to play full 4, but you even get it with Saga a lot, because a lot of time you play Saga on 2, so you get it early, and you end up just... Wait, I don't have 7 artifacts, was all that stuff? 1, 2, 3, 4, oh, only 5. All right, well, I still would have played it the same way. What was I saying? Yeah, a lot of time you end up getting the drum with Saga. That's how good it is. Because you're losing Saga, so you're losing a mana, but it makes everything cheaper, lets you like dump your hand. I wonder if they were baiting or if they just drew the Archroot. Doesn't really matter, I guess. I have 5 draw steps to draw a casket or a dispatch, and I think I'm in a decent shape. Okay. Makes my life easier. All right, removal, let's go. I managed to dodge the nuts. That's not it. One, two, okay, still 5 artifacts. I just play bridge. I also make my token first. But then I'm down to only 2 or 3 mana. I'll play the bridge first. Come on, removal. Hi-ya! Very nice. All right, so I won't have mana for casket. So I guess might as well play another monitor first. Oh, I mean, I won't have mana for Saga is what I meant. Who are we gonna Saga? Or who are we gonna casket? I'm really struggling. Let's get Archdruid, right? It's not especially close. Okay. Seachrome Coast a little awkward. And shut them down one more turn if I can draw another removal spell. Okay, that doesn't do much. As long as they don't get to 5 mana, they're stuck on land. I can make a token, get Shadow Spear, and I'm gonna have a really fast clock. Nice. Obviously, great draw. Get Shadow Sphere, I need it. Could maybe get Gravedigger's Cage if I'm worried about company or whatnot. I don't need to dispatch anything right away. Let's see. Let's send the flyers in. Maybe I'll agree to send the flyers in. Should at least draw two first, see what happens, do some math. I have dispatch for a lord though. Play another saga, keep drum up for dispatch. None of the creatures really do anything, so just save the dispatch in case they play a lord. I feel so suspicious that I'm not equipping. But who cares? Oh, Court of Calling. Guess I should have gotten Gravedigger's Cage. Probably just gonna get Archdruid though. That should be okay. Oh, that's no good. I'm actually dead on board. Because I got greedy and played Monitor. Let's see. Who deals most damage? Doesn't really matter. Any elf, right? Sucks. I think I'm just dead. Damn. That's good play by them getting the shaman and not just an archdruid. Wow. Don't lose because I attacked his monitor. 5, 6, 7, 8. Damn. I'd add another one. I had another card. All right, I guess I should have gotten Gravedigger's Cage. Expect Court of Calling. Beats. Good beats. That sucks because that's definitely, that was in my reach. All right, let's bring back a land in on the play. Every card was pretty good. Maybe Flare Husk is medium against them. All right, solid hand. Day Mulligans. I might save the Glass Gasket this game. Just save it for their free drop. We'll see. Pretty tempting to go Smith first. Yeah, definitely portable hole. A few extra zeros would be nice to pump Smith the turn it comes into play, but definitely not the priority. It's just a nice little bonus if you can. Yeah, it's kind of what I'm worried about when I let Mystic, wow. Might still be okay. Can portable hold Druids, Glass Gasket, their free drop. Wow. Okay, well then. That sucks. All right. So let's see, I only have one artifact. Yeah, I just have to use Glass Gasket on Lanor Oil. They're down to two cards. They might not have deferred lands. I guess Court of Calling would be good for them too. They probably have more than one Reclamation Sage. Choose creature or land, reveal the top four cards of the library, put all. Are you choosing creature or land? Creature. Got free. Didn't get anything great though. Well, that stuff's pretty slow. Slow and expensive. Guess my hand's not much better. No, my hand's pretty good. We're just stuck on lands. Ooh, one, two, three. No, that doesn't work. All right, let's do that. Artifact land would be nice. Nope. Oh, scary. It's Shaman. War Master plus Shaman is a lot of damage. Interesting. All right, gonna get rid of War Master. I might get rid of I'd have Court of Calling. And they get an elf, so they can get another elite, maybe. Get a token, get two tokens, and then their shaman deals a ton of damage, and then they can attack with a bunch. Yeah, I don't know. Looks like I might be able to stabilize here. Their hand's not especially good. Let's have a company. Oh my god. Oh, wrecked. I mean, that's not a tough matchup. It was kind of a miracle. I almost won two games. Man, I grabbed a Grisk Cage. I guess I was not that far from winning this game. Like, one Welding Jar. One Welding Jar for my Grab the Grisk Cage. Really? That's what they hit? Just perfects. Cool. Oh. I mean, I guess perfects would be a bunch of shamans and just kill me, but that's so brutal. Apparently I need Verdict in my sideboard. I keep losing to tribal decks, creature-based decks. All right, let's see. Let's see what we can do here. Not sure, not much. A bunch of 2/2s, that's cool. All right, GG's. Some solid hits. Tough matchup. While we wait for our next opponent, of course, video is brought to you by channelfireball.com. They're a marketplace now. You can buy cards from your favorite local game store, or you can just shop from one of the hundreds of local game stores that works with Channel Fireball in the marketplace. Find the best price. You can use my code YellowHat at checkout. That helps me out. And yeah, you can also check out CFB Pro if you're interested in deck guides and strategy articles from some of the best players in the world. Reed Duke, Huey Jensen, Andrea Mengucci. Well, I guess Huey's probably not going to be making too much content anymore since he's going to go work for Wizards. But you still have Juza, LSV, Aspiring Spike for Modern. So check out CFV Pro. You can get it for $5 a month, or you can get it for $20 a month, but you get $20 in store credit. So if you're going to spend money on Channel Fireball, you can kind of get CFV Pro for free. Pays for itself. I think you also get 5% cash back on every purchase. It's a little rake back. So yeah, check out the offers if you're interested. Just channelfireball.com or Google CFB Pro. Olerus deck, it's been a while. That's pretty much what you get. Not every round, but maybe every other round is Olerus deck. This hand is slow if they're playing Hammer Time. I might be in trouble if they're playing Grixis Shadow. This is a pretty solid hand. Looks like Hammer Time. The bad news about Sentinel is that it's just obnoxious. The good news is that means they're not maybe not comboing you as fast. All right, I got the value draw. Get another Sentinel. Let me just play my Saga to start making tokens, honestly. Either that or I can play Smith, and the next turn play Saga, play a drum, who cares? Yeah. I guess probably the way to go here. Citadel is nice. Portable Hole could be nice too. Probably have to take Portable Hole. Hope they don't have their own drum. They would have probably played it last turn. Really? What's going on here? Instant speed. You're really scared about an Ingenious Miss? I mean, it's all block Sentinel all day. One less artifact for their Saga. So let's see. They can technically kill me if they have Core Outfitter. But this works out because I get to keep Rebuke up. All right, this is pretty good. Yeah. I think Sentinel made more sense because of the tax and because it pumps their construct tokens. I'm going to take a few hits, but don't feel like it's going to be the end of the world. Let's see if they just get Shadow Spear here. They get a hammer. Shadow Spear. Mm-hmm. My own Shadow Spear, probably. Let's see. I have a lot of options. I have my drum in hand, actually. So I can play Flooded Strand. I can play drum. I could go like, how many artifacts am I going to have? The drum 4, Portable Hole 5, the artifact I get 6. I'm at 11. And they have a nest for Sentinel, so they can make their Smiths a 4-4, that token 5-5, potentially 6-6. Kind of looking at that Flare Husk, actually. Oh, wait, I'm going to eat a token. Sorry. So good onto 10. Play drum, play hole off a token. I have a 6-6 token. And their left was free token, potentially 4-4. They would need to have a removal for my token, which I don't think they play. So I don't need to get Flare Husk. I could just get Spellbomb for down the line. That's kind of a safe one. Could get Shadow Spear to start racing. That one's pretty nice too, to match their Shadow Spear. It's kind of tough. So many options. I think maybe I like Spell Bomb. I guess I don't have to play drum into portable hole. I can just play portable hole. 4-4. It's tempting to play the drum first though. All right, I'm gonna play the drum first because I don't think I can die. Unless obviously they have like Sigurd Arze plus land plus hammer. Well, GG's. I think I played it fine. None of the other lines would have really saved me. I guess I could have kept mana up. I didn't have to go for it. I don't know. I think my plays were fine. All right. Dispatch comes in. Casket comes in. Teferi comes in. Rebuke can go. Flare Husk can go. Relic can be trimmed. This Welding Jar can go. Nettle Cyst can be trimmed. I'm just going to play the value game. I'll just cut the Nettle Cysts. Turn one Sentinel into Urza's Saga. There's a bunch of artifact lands. It's not the worst hand in the world. Relies pretty heavily on Urza's Saga, but you're just a really good Urza's Saga deck, honestly. Want a shock here? Probably. Talisman would be a nice draw. Talisman, portable hole. Another Sentinel. Ooh, don't mind if I do. Take that for later. Thank you very much. Uh-oh, I have the turn two kill. I have 3 cards left. If you have it, you have it. guess it's hard for them to have turn to kill there. All right, I guess I'll take it this time. Why didn't they play a drum there? What do you have? Huh. Weird. Oh, right. I'm dumb. They didn't want to let me draw a card. So dumb. Why? Why no play? Why no play drum? All right. Let's see. Make a token. Get a spell bomb, then it's not as suspicious when I play Hallowed Fountain untapped. Like Shadow Sphere is probably what I should be getting. Maybe not. Maybe just spell bomb is good. Can start attacking. True, too many artifacts lands. All of them. Paladin's pretty scary. I knew they have a hammer. Are you paying your... Now let it resolve, they draw a card, and they get to kind of move it around. So two options, I can bounce the paladin, which I don't hate, they don't draw a card. They can't do anything cool, they have no good attacks. They've played a land, so they can't cast Paladin again. Have they played a land? I think they've played a land. Cast Paladin? No, they actually haven't played a land. Alright, I guess I'm gonna dispatch the Paladin. Pompey, sorry. Spell, any spell. Not bad. They have no cards in hand. So technically, if I let them draw a card, they can hit Core Outfitter. But that's Sorcery Speed, so I can still block it. So even Core Outfitter doesn't do anything. It was the president, President Macron, calling for his daily debrief on the arena meta. Told him I was busy with historic though. Yikes. Dakep 7. My 7 is pretty mediocre, honestly. It's a little bit better. It's a little slow though. It's really bad if they have Sentinel, obviously, but that's going to be most of your hands. That's going to keep all the removal. And dismiss in case I have a slow draw with Sentinel. Gives me a play. Own Sentinel would be great here. I guess there's a saga. Annoying. At the end of the world. No plays. I like that. I guess I should play the Smiths first. Bubble and my own Sentinel. Bubble's free artifact next turn, because I'm going to pay the tax first anyways. Sentinel doesn't do much anymore. I just take the bubble, honestly. And Sentinel always does a little something. Oh, Commando. Do I have to block here? I'd have to block this for a target artifact enchantment. Yeah, I'll probably block the attack. Not attacking. They're offering a trade with the Sentinel. But shrink Saga tokens. I'm going to trust them that if they're offering to trade. They mean it. Hopefully I can hold. I'll take too much damage. Oh, they played another saga? Yikes. Let's see, 1, 2, 3 artifacts. Do I need to sag bubble or should I keep it? I feel like I need to draw lands and... Yeah, I don't think it makes a ton of sense. down there during a Ferret Saga. Oh, need my own, I think, maybe. Need to pay. Need to use my dispatch right away. Well, I don't have the tax, even though it sucks. And I want to trade free damage for one damage. Am I ever winning this race? I mean, maybe at some point. I'll just say go. Could be two damage too if they just equip Shadow Spear on Sentinel. All right, how many artifacts am I up to? Three. Four was the bridge. Five was Glass Casket. Maybe I just go Glass Casket this turn. Glass Casket, pay. It's so miserable, but what can you do if they draw a triple saga? I see no point in attacking when they have a lifelinker. So sick that four cards in hand still, they have Lurus. If I drawn one Urza Saga, I could maybe keep up. I could just have one token that's bigger than all their tokens, but I'm not even sure that's going to be the case anymore. What a card. Yeah, maybe Spreading Seas in the sideboard would be nice. Maybe not four, but it's trying to play as many artifacts as possible. I have Paladin now. I have to Chum Block. Oh well. I got Harold. Game might have gone a tiny bit better for me if I just blocked the Sentinel. I would have taken more damage, but might have been a bit further ahead on cards. Yeah, I was drawing well too. Close. Close matches every time. I had a lot of close matches in my league, I think. There's a lot of 2-1s going on. It's kind of rough when they have turn one Sentinel every game. You don't exactly love to see it. And these dispatches, I mean, they've been good, but didn't solve my issues this game. I don't know if you can take too much stock in that third game, though, like Triple Saga against my all removal draw. Not ideal. Paladin's such a nightmare, though. That card's so annoying. Alpha Dragon 12345. Okay. Kahira. Yeah, it could be blue-white control. Not sure what else it would be. I guess that's not true. I used to play Omnap 60 cards with Kahira. If they're playing control, I'm going to go for kind of an aggressive draw, I guess. Save the bubble for my Smith. All right, I guess I'm just going to go that right away. Hope they don't have Spreading Seas. Spreading Seas kind of going to own me either way, I guess. Then I can sell a follow-up with another Ingenious Smith, even if they have Spreading Seas. Yeah, they have it. Oh, a Chalice for one. Oh, no problem. I'm gonna not sag the bubble, just maximize damage of the Saga. And get a token from Treasure Vault, and then I get to pump it on their turn too with Urza's Saga. As advertised, best card in the deck when it doesn't instantly die. Is it a charm? I could seal my token, but then when they seal it, theirs is only a 2/2. So not that big of a deal. All right, what should I get here? Welding Jar, Shadow Spear, Relic, Spell Bomb. Me, Spell Bomb. I just let them have my 2/2, right? My token. Don't play Sentinel Odyssey, they have Chalice. That would not be great. Kind of nice, have Lethal next turn. Always good. Looks like they might have another charm. Which is fine, I guess. Right, threatening lethal, etc. Don't want to play my Nettle Sitch pre-blockers or else they can steal it. I guess, how does it work? Is it the same as the tokens? Equip creature gets... Because it's my equipment and it's their token. So I think it might actually be big. I guess I'll play the bridge. It means I can't cast Thoughtcast and Nettle Sitch this turn, but it doesn't really matter. I can just let them deal with that and then cast Nettle Sitch. It's kind of nice. It beats Shark Typhoon. If that's what they have. Oh, Solitude, right? That's a thing. That is still a card. Horde targeting. Why is it not telling me who they're targeting? Oh well. If it's dismiss, I might want to save it with my spell bomb. What just happened? Whoopsie, I guess. That's why I couldn't tell what target is. All right, Teferi, Dispute, Veto. I'm assuming these cards are good. I'm not even sure. I mean, Veto just sounds kind of expensive, honestly. Wilding Charge is not the worst against Verdict. Portable Hold seems atrocious. Right, blue white control. Let me see if I have a blue white control deck build here. See what they look like these days. Oh, Spreading Seas, but they're gonna save that for Urza's Saga. They might have Stony Silence in the sideboard. I think some. I don't think no. I don't think that's a legit concern. Relic not great, Spellbomb not great either. Alright, this looks pretty good. No idea how this mashup goes. I was thinking it would not be super good for me. Just because of Spreading Seas, they can kind of pick you apart. What if I could keep getting draws like these? Good aggressive draws, lots of Smiths and Sentinels. And even that second game, if they had had Spreading Seas for my Saga, it'd been a different story. Still had the second Smiths, but. Okay. 1 mana for 2 mana, I'll take it. A little small victories. Let's see. Gotta pressure them. And they're stuck on land as well. Artifact land or Nettle Cyst? I think it was my hand. I take the land. I'd be so greedy not to. Is that for artifact actually? Well, I think it is. Damn. Nice. Could have maybe kept that welding jar for next turn. I'm gonna get to try another card. All right. Don't mind if I do. They only have a good play. They can bounce something. All right. No, that's pretty sweet actually against the Chalice. At least I killed a fair right away. Looks like I'm in a pretty good spot, really good spot. Let's see. Oh, I guess I have all 1 mana artifacts, actually. Damn. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, playing that Wailing Jar last turn was loose. So I almost want to take the land so I can pump my space right away. I guess I don't care that much. All right, I'll take Thought Monitor. Yeah, playing that Wailing Jar last turn was super spewy. Potentially game losing. How did I draw all these 1 minute spells? Where did they all come from? What the hell? Should play Cavern maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4. I could actually play Thought Monitor right away. I think that's a play. What am I worried about? Not much. And I get to pump my Smiths this turn and hopefully next turn again. Have played a land though, right? Yeah. I don't think it matters. I don't think I have a way to get rid of a chalice. One mana, draw two. Urza Saga. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Draw two. Dismiss. Well, that went super well. I'm gonna sit here and claim that's representative, but. If you can like have a couple of creatures in the early turn and draw an Urza Saga. Like Rebuke's kind of efficient against them. Let's see. If I play Saga, then I'm not pumping the Smiths. What could they have? Not sure. And technically, I could sag the treasure vault to pump dismiss. Give Shark Typhoon for two. If there's really anything they can do with my hand. I'm just gonna counter it because I can. Just in case they have a creature, I guess. All right. Does the easy mode version of the matchup? I'll take it. Just looked at my mic for a second. Thought I maybe forgot to unmute after talking to the president. Little moment of panic. Guess worst case, people get a good laugh out of it. Roast me in the comments. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments. I usually try to check at least once a week, even if it's not right away. When I don't, it's just because I forgot. Obviously, if you like the content, you know the drill, leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you want to see more. That definitely helps us out. And I have my own stream. I stream on Twitch, twitch.tv/yellowhat. If you want to come and watch that at some point, hang out, say hi. I play some modern, usually try to play the modern challenges on the weekend. Also play a decent bit of arena. Garbage aggro. Spirits? Oh, Sentinel. So might be, I was gonna say blue white. You know what, it might be. There's a version that's been doing well that is blue white hammer, but without Lurrus, and instead you get to play Nettle Cyst and Caldera Complete. So that might be what I'm up against. Could be Mirror Match, I guess. A small chance. Unlikely, though. I've been streaming the deck a bit and done well with it. Not impossible. Sword of the Meek. Okay, so it's Lopter. I mean, I gotta assume their Sentinel's better than mine. My hand's literally all non-creature spell. So I can go Saga Casket, slow them down a bit, then just play a land and start making tokens. Or I could delay a turn, play Shadow Spear. Next turn, play Shadow Casket and have mana for Rebuke. That might work out better for me, actually. Yeah, I like that line. This Casket on Stone Fortress is pretty bad. Because then if they have a portable hole, they get to get the trigger again. So that part's not great. We'll see. Maybe I'll just play Urza Saga and not do anything. Just say go. So they're gonna make a token, they're gonna make another token, get some utility. Kind of rough. Kind of feel like I need to save Glass Casket for the token. I don't know if I have time to really. Oh. We just cast Thoughtcast this turn. Not the worst. Okay, Treasure Vault, something. Wasn't exactly hoping for two lands, but could be worse. Pretty rare that I delay Saga by so many turns, but I think it's correct this game. I think it was the right line. If I can draw a portable hole, I'll be in good shape, I think. They didn't have a second Saga, that was nice. Hopefully that's just Sword of the Meek. Foundry, yikes. That's a problem. Now I really need portable hole, but for a different reason. Come on. Okay. Oh, I meant to play Urza Saga. Well, might be okay. Probably not, though. Ooh. Oh, that was bad. And that was bad as well. Okay, well then. Blown out. I might have been fine with Urza's Saga because Foundry, Sword of the Meek is annoying, but if I can make some tokens and just equip them with Shadow Spear, not even clear who wins that race because I keep adding artifacts to the board, maybe draw Nelsis down the line. I see that Urza, it's over. You can have infinite mana, infinite tokens, infinite life, infinite spells. But I have to tap out aggressively. I can't just keep falling further behind and behind. Man. Played the wrong land. It's happened to me too many times. I actually lost a really high stakes match late in the Swiss rounds of a Pro Tour because I played the wrong land. That was rough. It was like second to last round. If I win, I think I can maybe draw into the top eight. Or at least have a win and in. All right, I'm assuming this is too little, too late. Don't even have an artifact play. I can chump, got 7. I mean, guess I'll play that. No, I mean, there's no way, right? All right, let's not waste more time. All right, Glass Casket doesn't seem great against them. Teferi's probably decent. Welding Jar's probably bad. Relic could stop the combo. I don't think Gravedigger's Cage works, right? Dispute's probably decent against them. Counters Urza. Flare Husk, probably unnecessary. Yeah, I mean, I don't have a great thing against a combo. I have Portable Hole, I guess. Let's see. Dispatch Rod 2 is probably nice. Yeah, I'll do 3 relics, 1 dispatch. Alright, this looks pretty good. All disruption, pressure. Beat them down with Urza Saga. Not get too fancy. Maybe more dispatch is good. Cheap artifacts are so nice, though. Cheap artifacts are important. Rough league. At least we played against different deck every round. Some brews. Not even against some brews. I guess some off-meta decks. That was interesting. This hand's great. Obvi. Let's see. I guess I'll fetch for Hallowed Fountain. Very nice. Could have Spreading Seas in their sideboard, actually. Well, at least I get to draw a card of it. Consolation prize. Stoneforge, Smiths. I think I've actually seen that list and played that list. Which one was it? Blue White Urza. I think that's the version I build. And there was the deck I get. I think it was that. Yeah, I think that's what we're up against. I tried that deck. It was kind of okay. I think I actually went 1-4 in the league I played, but also felt like the day was fine. It happened sometimes. It was 1-4, all the games were kind of close. I'm gonna hold on to my Sentinel for sure, not give them the option for one damage. Option to choose. Whether to block or not. Close this for 0. I might not make the second token then. I might just cast Nettlesis next turn. Yeah. Interesting spot. So they have Explosives for 0. Right now it's only killing a token. It does kill the Nettlesis token. But then I still get to equip on Sentinel, which is nice. What am I going to get? It was Urza Saga. Could get Shadow Spear. I already have Spell Bomb. I could get a Relic. I'm worried it's second Relic. I mean, I could get a second Relic, why not? I'm gonna make the second token now, force them to sack right away. I'd give them time to do something else. And yeah, I'll just get a second Relic. Should have the combo part mostly covered. Even though you can keep saving your Foundry by sacking an extra artifact. Pretty hard to keep up for very long against double Relic. Explosives for 1 would be kind of nasty here, actually. Oh. Pithing Needle. Very nice. Oh, I actually drew the Shadow Sphere, so I can trample over some tokens. All right, definitely didn't consider Needle when picking second relic. Spell bomb? Do I need to be worried? That Urza? I'm dispatched for Urza. They do get a big token, but then their explosive's kind of awkward. I feel like they're spewing. Or maybe not, I guess they get 4 mana after Urza, I'm dumb. Yeah. Wow, that's actually a good play too. I'm just clueless. And they're playing great. All right, the good news is they don't have a ton going on here. Can dispatch Urza. They could have counterspell, actually. That would be brutal. I don't think that deck plays counterspell, though. Let's see. What are you drawing? Citadel. I'm just gonna play that now. Okay, they don't have a ton going on. They have Sword that can make a bunch of tokens by sacking a lot of artifacts. It's not too big of a deal. What do I take? The token, dash, and then I just get to equip. They have another removal spell though. Gonna have to start sacking these relics. I have to remember they can just start sacking their artifacts to foundry to finish me off. That's actually pretty legit concern, right? Do I have to chump? I don't think I can afford to. They also can't kill me, they have free mana, so they can make free tokens only. So they can't kill me next turn, and after that I just get to start swinging with Nelsis Shadow Spear. So if they're out of gas, I'll be okay. Playing pretty slow though, they might have a little something. All right, let's see. I can bounce that, equip. I should have played a land first in case they have rebuke. One, two, three, four, five. So do I want to equip and play bridge or play saga? I think I want to equip and play bridge. And I guess if they have a removal spell, I'll lose. Oh, I could have equipped attack, but then they can chump and I die on the crackback. Oh, no, I don't. What happens if I equip attack? They have to chomp, I go up to 15, and they only have like, because anytime they sack an artifact, they make, oh no, the construct stays the same size. No, okay, so I do die on the crackback. Oh, I forgot the name Spellbomb. Oh my god, I'm such an idiot. Oh, like this, chat. Oh my god. Awkward. Yeah. Forgot your name, Spellbomb. All right. Well, that's a lesson for you. Don't forget what they name on Needle. I don't know. I think this game was kind of okay. Not to win the third game, but oh, well, it happens. Anyone who made it this far, hopefully you got a good laugh out of it. As for the deck, I mean, I still think it's pretty good. Especially since Grixis Shadow is one of the best decks in the format, and my results against Grixis Shadow has been really good. I think it's decent against the Cascade decks. Hammer Time has been tough. Hammer Time has definitely been rough, so might not be quite a contender for a tier 1 deck, but it's been good and it's been fun. Anyways, that's going to be it for me this week. Hope you'll have a great weekend, a great week. If you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.